you're looking for the best Grand National tips for 2022, then we've got you covered. We have a horse-by-horse quick preview of all the horses for the Grand National, as well as our thoughts on the best picks leading up to the big race. Remember, with the Grand National, despite there being early favourites, the race is a lottery in terms of which selection ends up winning, with many incidents happening outside of the horses' and jockeys' control. In this video, we'll run through every horse from the outsiders to the favourites, ranking them from 1 star to 5 stars out of 5 for the best bets. We even give you a rundown of the top 4 horses we'd back as well, so stay tuned for that towards the end of the video. So without further ado, here are all 40 horses racing in this year's Grand National, and their chances of winning in our tipster's opinion. So to start things off, here are our 1 star horses. Easyland. Easyland has some clippets of form, but it's hard to see it getting competitive. Brahaba Bull. Trip not ideal and often makes mistakes, probably look elsewhere. Battle Over Doyen. Another inconsistent jumper and a tough ask in a race of this nature. Samcrow. Once classy, but hampered by injuries and looks on the downslide, hard to fancy really. Good Boy Bobby. The hustle and bustle of big fields is unlikely to suit this horse, probably look elsewhere. Lord Demensil. Very safe, but unfortunately not very quick, will probably need the rain to aid any chance. Caribbean Boy. Inconsistent sort, prone to errors, and hard to fancy. Topville Ben. Hard to fancy on the form book, tends to hang left, and others are preferred. Annabelle Fly. Shows little of late, will really need a return to its best, and there's no signs of that recently. Phoenix Way. Not the easiest horse to train, the stamina is a worry, and again hard to fancy. And our final 1-star horse is Class Conti, another horse that's hard to fancy on previous national form. Now for our 2-star horses. Lost in Translation. Some credible form to its name, but not really of late. It's hard to get too excited about this horse. 2 for Gold. Often front runs, didn't really impress in last year's Topham over the national fences. Mighty Thunder. Failed to complete its last 2 assignments, and a return to form looks unlikely in this one too. Dies Alba. Good form this year, but it does look tough. Others do appeal more. Augusta Gold. Jumping is often a letdown with this horse, and it could be out of depth here. Poker Party. Out of form recently and hard to make a case for after a poor show at Cheltenham last time out. Black Lion. This horse is 13 years old now, but in fine form until the last time out. It really does need to bounce back. Cloth Cap. This horse has a chance on best form. It does have a tendency to jump left, but it has weakened in the last year. Coco Dancer. Not sure the trip will be in his range, and it needs to settle better. Court Maid. Stays well, needs to improve on recent form to get involved. And now onto our 3-star horses. Manila Times. Manila Times won this race last year, and Rachel Blackmore takes to the saddle once again. This horse is sure to have plenty of admirers, but the season hasn't really gone to plan, so do take into account the form. Run Wild Fred. This is a highly rated horse. Races prominent with a very no-nonsense style. A big run at Cheltenham at the latest, so it should go well. Burrow Saint. This is Willie Mullins' strongest fancied runner, but it does have to prove that it can stay the trip. Mount Ida. This could actually be the dark horse of the race. It will be ridden with patience, and it will need luck in running. Far Class. First time cheap pieces could be the ticket. It was 5th last year, but it's definitely not to be taken lightly. Kildasart. This horse is well handicapped and did run well last time. It could run well at a nice price. Discorama. This will need plenty of luck in running, but it's no forlorn hope. And our final 3-star is Dingo Dollar. The course and the distance will suit, but it needs to improve its jumping to be very competitive. Now for our 4-star horses. The first, Delta Work. An outstanding performance to put toll to Tiger Roll's Cheltenham Swan Song. This horse is well handicapped, but there's a fear that its Cheltenham exploits could come back to haunt him. A big run is expected though. Any Second Now. This horse did well in the circumstances to finish second in the race last year. Longhouse Poet. Start the rain dance now if you're backing him. The softer the better, and it does tick a lot of boxes. Fiddler on the Roof. This horse is well handicapped, and a really solid effort last time out. It will relish this trip. Santini. Santini tends to stay well, jump well, and it's well handicapped. There's not a lot not to like here. A bold attempt is expected. Escaria 10. Closely matched with Any Second Now on their latest starts. The blinkers look a great decision. Derasha Counter. Been unfortunate with injuries, but a solid return after a break last time. This could surprise. Freewheeling Dylan. This horse won last year's Irish National, There's probably more on its plate here, but it could surprise again. Noble Yeat. Solid form, solid jumper, and an interesting jockey booking. Ticks almost every box and definitely has a big chance. Snow Leopard S. All heart. Jumps boldly and won't go down without a fight. Shortlisted horse. And the final 4-star is Death Duty. This is a grade 1 winner. Very well treated and 2 solid efforts this season. Sneaked in at first reserve and a definite dark horse in the race. And finally, there's our 1 5-star horse, which is Enjoy Darlin. Wrapped in cotton wool since its last year's third in the Irish equivalent. A good chase effort this term sandwiched between 2 fine hurdle attempts. Big money purchase for JP McManus with a race in mind. Jumps well, stays well, and laid out for this. This is probably the one to beat. So to summarise, here are our top picks for this year. Our first top pick is Enjoy Darlin. Our second is Noble Yeat. Our third, Death Duty. And number 4 is Snow Leopardess. Thanks a lot for watching, and good luck if you're betting in this year's Grand National.